Hey guys, welcome to Music for Wednesday, April 15th. We are going to continue talking about instruments of the orchestra, and right now we are on the string instruments, but I want to remind you guys that you will need your week packet. This week is April 14, 15, 16, so you will need not Tuesday, but you will need Wednesday. And if you look, we are going to be talking about the cello, the bass, and a string quartet. So let's get started, shall we, with the cello. Here we go. The cello is the second lowest string instrument in the orchestra. It's pretty big, but not as big as the bass. The cello players, or as they are known, cellists, and if you notice, I'm going to go back to this just a second, cello is spelled C-E-L-L-O. There's no H in it, but because it's an Italian word, you don't say cello, you say cello. The cellists have to place the cello sitting down because of how big it is. So you put the cello between their knees. The actual name of the cello is violoncello, but we don't say that whole name, we just call it the cello. Usually there are 8 to 12 cellists in an orchestra, so it's not as big of a section as the violins. There's always the most violins in any orchestra because there's a first violin and a second violin, so there's really two parts. The cello can play other genre or types, styles of music, such as pop, jazz, and neoclassical. So we are going to watch a video of cellos. Now, again, you get to this by clicking the link on your packet. So here we go. Let me see if I can find where I put it. Here we go with cello. He's holding it between his knees, but his knees aren't really holding it. There's an end pin at the bottom that's holding it up. Girls with long hair, sometimes yes, your hair does get stuck in the cello, so you usually either pull it back in a ponytail or you tuck it on the other side so that doesn't happen. Okay, for more of this, you will click the link in your packets. Next, we have the biggest instrument in the string section, which is the bass. You notice, bass is spelled B-A-S-S. It is not bass the fish. We do not go fishing in music. In music, we pronounce it bass. You can have a bass all you want to when you go fishing, but it's bass. It's known as the double bass. It can be the string bass, upright bass, or just the bass. It's the lowest and the biggest. It's about as tall as me, actually, to give you some kind of a idea of how big it is. It has to be played standing up, or sometimes they give you a stool to sit on that you can adjust your height so that you're at the right height to play it, and so you can sit down and not have to stand up for a whole concert. You can pluck it again, like you saw in the cello video, but when string instruments pluck it, it's called pizzicato, and then you can use your bow too. A lot of times they have the bass playing by plucking or pizzicato. Like the other string instruments, the bass bows are strung with horsehair, but, and it doesn't hurt the horses when they use it, just like it doesn't hurt you when you get your haircuts. But unlike the other instruments, sometimes it's a combination of black and white horsehair because it looks cool, and because the bass strings are so thick, sometimes they need a little bit of extra hair. Basses play in orchestra, but they are also a lot of times found in jazz bands, which is why they do a lot of the plucking or the pizzicato, because of the bass lines. Bluegrass bands, blues bands, and many more. So here we go with listening to and watching the string bass, electric bass. Not always, but sometimes electric basses are also used in jazz band. Electric basses are played same strings as the string bass. We'll get to that in a little bit. Double bass, all the same kinds of things. So here we go with the bass. Get to the bass. All right, this one. Oh, and this one they call it an upright bass. It's still the same instrument. It just has many names. The dog is just sitting there and enjoying it. If you're wondering what this is right down there, that's someplace where they often put their bow to store it. Only bass players have that. All of the other people, their instrument isn't big enough to have a holder right there. Just like the other videos, you can click on the link and watch the rest of it. We've got one more thing to talk about, and that is what happens when you put more than one person together. And we call that an ensemble, or in this case, a string quartet, when two violins, one viola, and one cello play all together. They kind of leave the bass player out of this, and I don't know why. String quartets are a very popular type of chamber ensemble or a small performing group. It's called a chamber ensemble because they used to play in a small chamber for the prince or the king or the duke, and it just kind of kept that name. Even though we don't usually play in a chamber anymore, we play on a stage or in a someplace else, but nobody says, hey, I'm gonna go play in your chamber. The composer Haydn is known for developing the string quartet as he composed many pieces for a group with this instrumentation. So we are going to watch and listen to a string quartet. And remember, it's got two violins, one viola, and one cello. So let's watch. And I'm sure you will be very impressed because this group is made up of young kids, and it's a pretty except for this one does have a bass, and it looks like they just have two violins, a cello, and a bass. But this one is not a classical group. The next one we watch will be the classical instrumentation. And you can again click on your link and watch the rest of that. It's pretty amazing, especially with how young they look, that they can play that well. Must have a lot of practice, just like I know you guys could do if you had those instruments. Click on the links, watch all the videos, and we will continue with our strings group tomorrow. And I'll talk to you guys later. Have a great rest of your day. Bye.